Okay, warm welcome to everyone. Is it my audio video is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we will going to start with electrostatics. Okay, and here, if you remember in the last lecture, we have done it all the synopsis part and the revisionary concepts of 11th standard electrostatics. And at the end of a lecture, I had given you one assignment, and that assignment is actually based on the application of the Gauss's law only. So let us first upon discuss the solution. What is the required solution of that question? Has anyone tried it? Or anyone have got any answer or any clue? You're free to share with me so that I can go to proceed for the next part. Otherwise, I will show you that is how the solution can be going to come for that problem or the case which we have discussed about. Say, if this is the surface area, okay, if this is the surface area and its directionality would be on the, say, ds vector in this direction, okay, this is a surface area basically, it is moving, or I can say it has a direction on this side. Similarly, the electric field is also arriving and start moving through the surface area. And here you will obtain E and DS are parallel to each other. Okay, both of them are vectors only. Your electric field is a vector, DS, that is surface area vector, it is also a vector. So both the vectors are in the same direction and they are actually parallel to each other. So here the theta, that is the angle formation between them, is become completely 0 degree. Then I've asked you how I can use this condition in Gauss's theorem. First of all, let me remind you the Gauss's law over here. The Gauss's law is related to electric field or electric flux, that is close integral of E vector dot ds vector, which is equal to charge enclosed. Okay, so this was the expression we obtained for the Gauss's law. Now my question was, if this theta is zero, what can we going to predicting? Okay, on the basis of Gauss's law. So it's very simple, student. What I can going to do is, I will consider the flux which is generating over this surface area. Iska matlab, yaha pe kitna electric flux generate hone wala hai, ye hum log calculate kar sakte hai. How? So let us consider the flux of electric field phi E is close integral. I can write down E dot ds as E ds cos theta. Why I can go to write down this? Because it is matching with the identity called A vector dot B vector. And A dot B will be nothing but AB cos theta. This is the magnitude of A dot B vector. So similar, I have considered E vector as one of the vector and ds is the another vector. So these both vectors are having the dot product. So I can write down their dot product's magnitude as E ds cos theta. Now, what we can do? we can substitute this theta value over here. Then what will be the answer? So therefore, electric flux close integral E ds cos 0 degree. Does anyone know what is a cos 0 value? Yes, cos 0.
1.
Very good. Cos 0 is 1. So when cos 0 value will become 1, ultimately this flux value is also become phi of E, that is electric flux, close integral E ds. Now student, if you clearly observed over here, electric field will remain constant. Okay. Only the perception or our assumption of ds can be changed, because ds is variable. It depends person to person that ds value or the what we can say choice of ds can be changed. But electric field won't be going to change. Electric field is totally depend on the number of charge, and whatever the charge will be there, according to that electric field is also persisting over there. So now student, it's very simple. We can take E outside the integration. So here close integral of ds we will obtain. Now student, I don't know what is the surface area. I generally consider this surface area as a circular surface area. Okay, so if suppose there are so many circular kind of a surface area, I will combine them. Definitely I will obtain the flux for this kind of surface area, or this case where theta equal to 0. So in this case, I may get some value, that is close integral of E dot ds. Definitely afterwards, if I'm going to integrating all the small surface elements, surface areas, I will obtain some fluxed value, that is E into the terms of surface area integral. So this is the part I'm talking about. So from this equation, or from this condition and this equation, they both of them are satisfied and giving us some value of flux. Iska matlab, ye apne ko kuch na kuch to value de raha hai flux ka. Jo bhi E into integral of ds hoga, utna. Theek hai, I will hold this as equation one. Then the second case was, suppose if this is the surface area, like this. This is the second case. This is the surface area. And we know the surface area direction was upward, because it is keeping in this way, na, in this manner. That's why iska jo direction hoga, ye upward mein hoga. Then your electric field intensity will be passed through it. Electric field intensity will going to pass through it. And definitely if it has some thickness, it will try to pass through that thickness of the surface area. If it doesn't have any thickness, maybe it will be passing on parallel to the surface area generally. Okay, but now here what we can obtaining is the electric field intensity is passing, okay, on the surface area in a such a way this surface area vector and E makes some angle. Okay, it makes some angle, and that angle is 90 degree. So I will say theta in this case is 90 degree. Now, if I'm going to use the same Gauss's law over here for the terms of flux, or for the requirement of flux, I may write down phi of E close integral E vector dot ds vector. Now again, what we can do with this equation? Yes, again, we will compare it with the standard vector equation or standard vector product. And we can write down flux, okay, close integral E ds cos theta, similar to like this equation. But now our theta value has been changed. Now close integral E ds cos of 90 degree we have to take. Once we are going to take a cos of 90, can anyone tell me what will be the value of cos 90?
Zero.
Sorry, pardon?
Zero.
Okay. So if this flux is equal to close integral E ds and cos 90 value is 0. This 0 multiplied by e ds, which makes this entire right-hand side equation or entire right-hand side term will be 0. And here, what we can obtain, obviously, flux is equal to 0. I will call this as equation number 2. Now, final conclusion based on equation 1 and 2. As you can clearly see over here, student, this flux value is coming something. Definitely not 0, but coming something. Like it has some value. It contains some value. Okay? Whereas equation 2, it's ultimately showing there is a value of the flux will be become 0. So from this only, we can predict at this case, when theta equals to 0, our flux value, this flux value is become maximum. So there will be a probability we are getting the maximum flux value when theta equal to 0, when surface area and electric field, both of them in the same direction. So yes, definitely the flux would be obtained as much as maximum value. But when your electric field and your surface area vector makes an angle in the 90 degree, this makes there is no such flux can be generating inside the surface area. For generating the flux, what should be the necessary? What is the necessary condition? The electric field line should be passed through the surface area. It is not like this. The surface area is keeping like this and electric field are trying to go, but they are actually going from the upward or downward position of the surface area. So there will be hardly any chance of electric field intensity can be penetrate the surface area. So this is what the condition where we can obtain the flux has become maximum at this case.
Hello,
and hello, yes. Yes, anyone have any doubt? Okay. And this is the second case where we can say least ya to minimum bol sakte or almost zero bhi bol sakte. So that is almost a very least condition at which we can obtain the flux. I can say surely there will be no flux can be generating when such case is going to be occur. So this was a solution, student, I'm expecting from yourself. Okay. So please remember how we can going to deal with these angles and how we can going to be prove it the flux can be the maximum to minimum range of the value. Okay, student. One more thing. If suppose this can be happen, maybe this can be happen. Suppose this surface area not probably will be in the say in the same direction. Maybe it will tilt some by the some say orientation. I can show you that part also. Suppose surface area is like, if surface area is somewhat in the orientation, okay, this is the surface area. So definitely the surface area vector is ds in this direction, and electric field intensity, suppose if it is passing through it, okay, so how it will be looks. So the electric field intensity is like this. And if we know the angle between them, okay, not sure of zero or the 90 degree, maybe in between them, okay. So if you know the angle between electric field intensity and ds vector, you can simply calculate what amount of flux has been going to generating inside the surface. Okay, so kitna flux generate hone wala hai, ye hum log easily predict kar sakte hai agar humko electric field aur ds ke beech ka angle pata ho. Ye to standard condition ho gaya ki jahan pe 0 ho sakta hai aur jahan pe 90 ho sakta hai, but you may get the variable flux according to the varying angles between E and DS. So please remember ki surface area or electric field ke beech ka agar angle aapko pata hai, you can simply substitute in this equation and you may obtain the flux generating at that instant. So this was the part of assignment, student. Okay, clear hai? Understood?
Yes,
sir.
Pakka na? Kisi ko koi doubt hai isme se related koi bhi condition mein? Ye zero samajh mein aa raha hai, 90 समझ में आ रहा है, और अगर 0 और 90 के बीच का कोई भी वैल्यू होगा तो आप ये वाला प्रिंसिपल अप्लाई करोगे, बट मेथड सेम रहेगा, सिर्फ एंगल चेंज हो जाएगा. ओके, तो शैल आई प्रोसीड टू एवरीवन?
यस सर.
वेरी गुड.
यस
गुड. तो चलो चलते हैं फिर आगे. आज अब हम लोग 12th स्टैंडर्ड का जो इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स का पार्ट है वो स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं. वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीडिंग द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स ऑफ द 12th स्टैंडर्ड. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड वी विल बी गोइंग टू डीलिंग विद एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ गॉसेस लॉ. तो अभी गॉसेस लॉ क्या है ये तो बहुत अच्छी तरह से समझ गया है लास्ट लेक्चर में. इवन वी नो द मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला दैट इज phi of E is equal to close integral E vector dot ds vector is equal to total charge enclosed upon permittivity. So, ye tha apna expression. Okay, based on that, student, we have a three applications over here in 12th standard. Those are very simple applications. Only you should try to understand the situation and the condition around which the charges are distributed. Simple language में ये बात कर सकते हैं कि अगर आपको ये पता चल जाता है कि charges का distribution कैसे किया है तो आप उस condition के ऊपर से ये calculate कर सकते हो कि कितना electric field intensity present है उस particular conductor के around. तो चलो start करते हैं. So here I am going to be start with the very first application of Gauss's law from our 12th standard series. Is electric field intensity, electric field intensity due to uniformly charged spherical shell, or instead of shell you can also consider hollow sphere. So this is what our aim, electric field intensity due to uniformly charged spherical shell or hollow sphere. But now I will going to ask you simple two questions. How we can going to represent the electric field intensity by which letter? इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी किस लेटर से इंडिकेट करेंगे? इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड यस स्टूडेंट, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आर गोइंग टू बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय, यस वेरी गुड, कैन यू से इट अगेन ई, वेरी गुड, कैपिटल ई इज रिजर्व फॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी. देन ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज spherical shell or hollow sphere. So here we have already gotten an idea that our conductor is of in the shape of spherical shell or hollow sphere. So now I can say the idea is completely clear. Our aim is also completely clear that we have to derive an expression, we have to obtain an expression in terms of electric field intensity. हम लोगों को इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी के टर्म में एक इक्वेशन बनाना है या तो एक्सप्रेशन फाइंड आउट करना है जो एक स्फेरिकल शेल या तो होलोस्फीयर के अराउंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड को रिप्रेजेंट करेगा. सो यस, लेट्स वी कैन गो टू स्टार्ट विद द कंडीशन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. तो अभी देखो स्टूडेंट यर, व्हाट इज नेसेसरी थिंग फॉर डिराइविंग एनी एक्सप्रेशन और एनी काइंड ऑफ अजम्पशन, वी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टार्ट विद द रूट ऑफ दैट कंसेप्ट. And the root of the concept is nothing but we have to visualize it, we have to draw it, we have to make some standard visualization, we have to make some standard models, and based on that standard model we will going to be find out what is the necessary or the required things. So your electric field intensity is our aim, and only they had given the charge shell or the hollow sphere. Now what I will going to do is I will first upon putting in front of you the conductor. So how that conductor is look like? Yes, that conductor is of in the spherical shape. Okay, so that conductor is in spherical shape. Please consider this is as a uniformly spherical conductor. Okay, and this is the center of that spherical shell, and I will say this is the radius of that spherical shell. Okay, please consider this is a uniform one. Okay, and now student, let us distribute the positive charge on the surface of this conductor, which means we have electrified it, this charge conductor, this spherical shell, by positive charges. So in this way, the positive charges are placed it on the surface of this shell. Understood up to this student? So this is what they're given, which is already reflecting from the heading. यहाँ तक सबको समझ में आ गया क्या किया? एक spherical
shell,
बराबर ना? एक spherical shell. Very good. We have considering one spherical shell and we have distributed the surface by the charges of the positive. Okay. So in this way, we can say now this charge, now this conductor, specifically the spherical shell, is charged and uniformly charged. It's not like an oddly charge. We have charges, or we have putting the charges, we have placing the charges in the uniform condition, uniformly. Now, if you think about it, student, this spherical shell will be surrounded by the charge. Obviously, we will obtain the electric field intensity near about this region due to these charges, we can obtain the electric field intensity near about this region. Am I right? Yes, student. Is positive charge ke wajah se apne ko is surrounding region mein electric field intensity feel hoga. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Chalo. Let's move it to the next part. Now, from that only, if one is trying to find what is the intensity of this electric field, which is creating due to this number of set of charges. So definitely Gauss's law will going to help us. But Gauss's law has some restriction. Gauss's law tells us you can be going to find out the electric field intensity, but provided that charge should be enclosed. Charge ko kahin pe band hona chahiye. Agar charge band hoga, to main us closed surface ke ऊपर या उस क्लोज ऑब्जेक्ट के बाहर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी को कैलकुलेट कर सकता हूं. तो गॉसेस लॉ तो यही बताता है कि आई कैन गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी प्रोवाइडेड दैट चार्ज शुड बी इनक्लोज. बट नाउ यू विल ऑब्टेन द चार्जेस आर अराउंड दिस स्पेस. ओके, द चार्जेस आर अराउंड दिस स्पेसेस एंड द रीजन वेयर नियर अराउंड दिस स्पेसेस वी कैन गोइंग टू ऑब्टेन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी. डेफिनेटली यस. बट नाउ माई क्वेश्चन इज, now it's become very difficult. Okay, we can't going to send these charges inside the conductor. Is it be possible? Kya kisi ke paas koi aisa method hai ki is charges ko andar introduce kar de? Because this is spherically shell, or this is compact, this is a compact one shell. Okay, this is completely a tight shell, and then my question is, can we going to send these charges inside? Kya andar isko bhej sakte hai aisa koi method karke? Generally, pardon, can you repeat?
Sir, if we put negative charge inside the sphere, then can we attract them, the positive?
But now one? scenario is, if this is a spherical shell, okay, this is completely a hard conductor. Okay, this is a completely hard conductor. For sending the charge inside, we have to break it this conductor. Then and only you can going to send whatever the negative charge inside it, and then, but if I'm going to break that spherical shell, I will going to easily try to pass it or try to set up the positive charge instead of negative one. No, if I'm going to break it, but yes, after breaking this conductor, it won't be make any sense of like a Gauss's theorem, because obviously the air present around this charge conductor will try to go inside. And then it will going to disturb the medium permittivity. Basically, what I can going to suggest, I just want to find out the electric field intensity over the surface. So there is nothing any sense which makes to just break down this conductor and then send it the charge inside and then close it. Then what's the thing over here? Okay, without breaking the conductor, we have to find out the electric field intensity. So that's a very important condition or the challenge for us. That's why what Gauss suggests, listen carefully, everyone. What Gauss suggests, do one thing, take an imaginary shape of shell or the spherical charge conductor and just draw it around this physical conductor. which means you have to draw it a imaginary shell. You have to draw it an imaginary shell, okay, around this physical conductor. And this imaginary sphere will have, or I can say, this is Gaussian surface of shell. So here what I am trying to introduce is one of the imaginary circle, imaginary sphere kind of a thing, which is closed, which is enclosed the physical conductor along with the charge. इसका मतलब मैंने यहाँ पे क्या करने की कोशिश की है कि मैंने इसी शेप को कंसीडर करके एक बड़ा इमेजिनरी सर्कल बना लिया, एक शेल बना लिया, ओके? और फिर ऐसे बताने की कोशिश की है कि जो फिजिकल कंडक्टर है वो इस इमेजिनरी सर्कल, इस शेल के अंदर प्लेस्ड है. तो इससे जो गॉस का जो मेन अजम्पशन था दैट चार्जेस शुड बी इनक्लोज, ये सेटिस्फाइड हो जाता है. यस डेफिनेटली. नाउ द चार्जेस आर इनक्लोज बाय हुम, कैन एनीवन टेल मी? नाउ चार्जेस आर इनक्लोज बाय गॉसियन सरफेस. वेरी गुड. गॉसियन सरफेस ने चार्जेस को इनक्लोज कर दिया, बस बात खत्म. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फ्री टू यूज दिस गॉस थ्योरम. अब गॉस थ्योरम यूज कर सकते हैं, अभी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा, क्योंकि हम लोग ने ऑलरेडी अज्यूम कर लिया है कि दिस चार्ज कंडक्टर इज अंडर द गॉसियन स्फीयर. ओके, अब ये गॉसियन स्फीयर जो कंसेप्ट होता है ना स्टूडेंट, दिस इज बेस्ड अपॉन द इमेजिनरी फील्ड वर्क और इमेजिनरी ड्रॉ आउटलाइन. We can draw an outline around the charge conductor, whatever would be the shape of a conductor. Okay? तो जो भी shape होगा उस shape का हम लोग यहाँ पे Gaussian surface बना सकते हैं. तो ऐसे ही हम लोग ने यहाँ पे Gaussian surface बना लिया with respect to charge shell. अब student, if we are going to talking in terms of this Gaussian surface or Gaussian sphere, I may say this Gaussian surface or the Gaussian shell has radius small r. अब हम लोगों को ये बोलना पड़ेगा कि अगर ये गॉसियन स्फीयर है तो इसका भी कुछ रेडियस होगा, एंड दैट रेडियस इज स्मॉल आर. वी आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग दैट बाय स्मॉल आर. नाउ इफ यू जस्ट कंपेयर इट आर एंड स्मॉल आर, कैपिटल आर एंड स्मॉल आर, हु विल बी द ग्रेटर वन?
स्मॉल आर.
एग्जैक्टली, बिकॉज द गॉसियन सरफेस इज डायमेंशनली ग्रेटर देन द फिजिकल कंडक्टर, सो दिस इज स्मॉल आर इज ग्रेटर देन कैपिटल आर. यस डेफिनेटली स्टूडेंट. नाउ here what we have to do is we have to consider any one of or any at a random place one surface area vector. To hum log abhi kya karenge, is Gaussian surface ke upar ek ds vector ya to surface area vector consider kar lete hain. To main kya karta hu, yahan pe ek surface area consider kar leta hu. ये है मेरा सरफेस एरिया, ओके, सरफेस एरिया वेक्टर ऑफ द गॉसियन सरफेस, ओके. आई विल कॉल दिस एज डीएस. बाय द वे, ये डीएस कहाँ पे फॉर्म किया है पता? ये डीएस है एट पॉइंट पी ऑन द गॉसियन सरफेस. अंडरस्टूड एवरीवन? यहां तक समझ में आ गया सबको? शैल आई प्रोसीड? व्हाट आई हैव डिड इज आई हैव कंसिडर द गॉसियन सरफेस. यस अंडरस्टूड अप टू योर. We have to consider one surface area vector over here at point P. Okay. Now, as you can see from here only, physically you can see this surface area vector can be having the directionality in this sense or in this way. ये ऐसे जाएगा straight ये direction में. Obviously, ये जो charges है, these are the charges which are enclosed by the Gaussian surface. They also have electric field intensity. They can also form the electric field, and that electric field is also moving, also traveling in the same direction, say E vector. So they are parallelly traveling, okay, outward the Gaussian surface. One more thing, student, here. Now, what can be happen if I am going to relating E vector and ds vector? What can be the angle between them? Can anyone tell me? What will be the angle between E vector and ds vector? Because both are same.
Zero degree.
Zero will be. Well done. Zero will be. So now, here, can we going to use this expression again? Everyone, can we going to use this expression again? Exactly. So here, I will write down phi of E, that is the electric flux, that is the flux, electric flux of this surface area ds. Okay, that is close integral E vector dot ds vector. Is it clear? Is it clear? Yes, phi is equal to line integral close integral E dot ds. But as you can go into see your E vector and ds vector are forming the angle zero, na? Yes, everyone. Angle zero, na? Theta is equal to zero, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes, let us expand. Yes, okay, let us expand this. Tell me, phi of E equal to what should I going to write down here?
Zero.
Directly. Directly zero, likh denge. Shall we going to write down directly zero and close integral? Khatam.
No, sir.
E dot d.
Exactly. What I'm expecting is E ds cos theta. Understood?
Yes.
As here we are expanding there, yes, in the term of dot product of E dot ds. Now, E dot ds expansion is E ds cos theta. Now, let us substitute the zero value here and then tell me what will be the value. E ds cos 0 degree. Cos 0 का वैल्यू अभी आपने बताया था कितना हो जाएगा बच्चे लोग
1
so now e ds cos 0 is 1. Understood up to this?
Yes, sir.
Now again, see student, our aim is to find out the electric field intensity. Correct, exactly. But now in the initial stage we are trying to find out how much flux is generating एट दिस सर्फेस डी एस. इस सर्फेस के ऊपर कितना फ्लक्स जनरेट होने वाला है ये अभी फिलहाल हम लोग के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट हो गया है. इसलिए हम लोग ने phi of E is equal to close integral E ds कर दिया. But now the question is, whatever will be the electric field is coming outside from or throughout this ds, that is nothing but coming from these charges, and these number of charges will be settled and will be remain as it is. There is nothing is going to be increment taken place in this charges. Once we have set up the charges and their number will be remain as it is. So as their number has become as it is, their electric field intensity strength is also remaining as it is. That's why student, here, if I'm going to try to calculate further more steps, I have to take this E vector outside the close integral and write down ds. Because if you know that integration suggesting us, integration won't be going to act on the constant term. It always going to be sending that constant term outside the integration. Am I right? Kya main sahi baat kar raha hu? Integration constant ke upar act hota hai? Integration constant ke upar kabhi act hota hai kya?
No.
It will never going to be act. It will be acting on the variables. So like here in this case, ds can be variable. Now see, how I can be going to prove that ds is variable. Let us say, agar koi aap mein se bolega ki sir, why you have considering this ds? Do one thing now. Sir, this is not my word. This is a student is suggesting me. Sir, please take this surface area ds. So I can going to be deny him or her. I can say, haan, theek hai, chalo, le lo. Abhi aapne bola hai, toh aap ye surface area le lo. Woh bolega, sir, I will going to take it to this surface area or this surface area vector. There is nothing wrong in that. Okay, then what is going to happen? Yes, I am going to draw it the distance that will become again the smaller. If all of a sudden the third student will come and he said, sir, do one thing now, sir, please do consider this much surface area, sir. Consider this much surface area. Ye ek surface area le lijiye na. Ye itna chote se kya hoga? Isse kya kare? Isse kya kaam banega? Ye kuch bhi nahi, useless hai. Aap ye bada surface area le lo. Fir baad mein to fourth wala jo aayega, wo to height hai ekdam. वो बोलेगा सर एक काम करो ना यहां से बहुत बड़ा एक सरफेस एरिया ले लो आप. नाउ एट दिस पॉइंट नो वन इज रॉन्ग, एवरीवन इज करेक्टिंग, एवरीवन इज सजेस्टिंग बाय देयर ओन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सो हियर देयर विल बी अ चॉइस ऑफ टेकिंग द सरफेस एरिया वेक्टर अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर अजम्पशन और अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर चॉइस. कोई भी शेप का अगर आप यहाँ पे सरफेस एरिया वेक्टर ले लोगे तो चलेगा. मतलब उसका अगर मैग्नीट्यूड आप not necessary, you can going to take it a point wise also, or you can take it as a patch wise also. So there is nothing in the wrong in everyone's assumption or everyone's choices. So my main conclusion from here is, if I'm going to dividing this entire Gaussian surface, okay, please listen carefully, student. This is very important. If I'm going to dividing this entire Gaussian surface into number of surface areas, like small regions, if I'm going to draw it, yahan se start karenge, banate 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 banate, fir yahan tak pahunch jayenge. And if I'm going to take the integration, agar main un sabko ek kar dunga, toh what geometry I will get? Listen carefully. If I'm going to draw it very small surface areas over here, and if I'm going to combine them, ultimately what geometry I will get?
Sphere.
Very good. Sphere. Because you are selecting the surface areas or the surface area vectors on the Gaussian shell, and the Gaussian shells itself geometry is in sphere or circular one. So that's why, student, here the close integral of all the small surface element over this Gaussian surface will be nothing but, here I'm going to write down the integral value of this integration ds is nothing but, my dear student, 4 pi r square. And this is the equation number one. Can anyone tell me what is 4 pi r square?
Surface area of sphere.
Exactly. It's a surface area of a sphere. After integrating all the surface areas ds, I will obtain the major or the total surface area of the sphere. That is nothing but for the Gaussian surface, my dear student. Understood up to this? यहां तक सबको समझ में आ गया? किसी को कोई भी डाउट है? Anyone have any doubt regarding about this? Any step? कोई ऐसा step जो नहीं समझ में आया? You can please ask.
No, sir.
पक्का? Sure. Shall I consider this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, चलो. Good. Good job. Now, up to this, I have obtained the equation one. अरे वाह, क्या बात है? Equation one मिल चुका अभी अपने को. अब हमको क्या करना है? What we have to do? I will just make one statement over here. According to Gauss's law. According to Gauss's law. What is Gauss's law? Gauss's law is electric flux phi E is equal to close integral of E vector dot ds vector, which is equal to total number of charges enclosed by the closed surface. And I will call this equation number two. Understood? Yes, everyone. क्या किया? अभी Gauss's law को लोगों को पता चल चुका है. Last lecture से पता चल गया है कि Gauss's law क्या है. Now we will not going to be derive it. We will directly consider this as a standard formula, standard law. Now, student, can you please compare equation one and two? Or is there anything which can be comparable in between equation one and two? ऐसा कोई पार्ट है जो कंपेयर हो सकता है इक्वेशन वन और टू से? वेरी गुड. इक्वेशन वन सजेस्टिंग द फ्लक्स, इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स ड्यू टू दिस गॉसियन सरफेस, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द गॉसियस लॉ दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स इज टोटली बेस्ड ऑन द नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस विच इज इनक्लोज बाय द सेम गॉसियन सरफेस. सो आई विल राइट डाउन फ्रॉम वन एंड टू. From 1 and 2, I will write down E into 4 pi r square is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. Now, student, what was our beginning or initial aim? What was our aim? What we are trying to calculate?
Electric field intensity.
Can anyone tell me around this equation, is there any notation, is there anything which can be representing electric field intensity? Aisa koi part hai jo electric field represent kar raha hai? E. So I will write down E is equal to, because I want to find out electric field intensity, so my equation is also going to be in terms of electric field intensity, E equal to. Ab isko sabko yahan pe bhej do, chalo yahan pe isko bhej dete, to yahan pe bhejne ke baad, what I will going to do is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This is what I am making an arrangement, and along with Q upon R square. And now, student, this is the expression for electric field intensity due to uniformly charged shell or hollow sphere. So how much it is? It is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, depend on the charge and depend on the Gaussian surface ka radius. So this is what E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. So this is nothing but the expression of electric field intensity due to uniformly charged spherical shell or hollow sphere. Understood, student? Samajh mein aaya aapko? Kuch bhi difficult part nahi tha. Ekdam simple tha. Equation 1 or 2 ko sirf aapko relate karna hai. Then quickly you have to be memorized that why we are doing this? Kyun kar rahe hai ye sab? Because of finding the electric field intensity of what? This spherical charge conducted. And that will be coming around E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. What is Q? Q is these are the charges, these number of charges. What is R? At what distance they are from the center of the conductor to the Gaussian surface. So once if you know the charge, if you know the Gaussian surface radius, you will easily calculate the electric field intensity present near about this region. Clear, student? Dekho kitna simple tha na? Yes, understood up to this?
Yes.
Okay. But picture abhi baki hai mere dost. Yahan pe ek cheez aapko dekha rahega, aapne dekha hoga yahan pe. One thing you have already observed that there is no single charge. Okay? There is no single charge. Or I can say for a simplicity, if I'm considering this surface area, अगर मैं ये सरफेस एरिया को कंसिडर करता हूं तो ये किसको इनक्लोज कर रहा है, देखो आप लोग अच्छे से, ये किसको इनक्लोज कर रहा है, तो ये एक सिंगल चार्ज को इनक्लोज कर रहा है. मैंने यहाँ पे क्या किया पता, व्हाट आई हैव ट्राइड टू ड्रॉ इट, कैन एनीवन टेल मी, यहाँ पे मैंने क्या ड्रॉ किया है पता, व्हाट आई हैव ड्रॉ इट इज, कोई बताएगा यहाँ पे क्या ड्रॉ करने की कोशिश की है? दिस इज द कंसेप्ट कॉल्ड सॉलिड एंगल, राइट ना, दैट थ्री डिमेंशनल एंगल, दैट इज कॉल्ड सॉलिड एंगल. So that solid angle actually envelop or engage this positive charge. ये इस positive charge को engage करना. तो अब यहाँ पे जो electric field intensity आपको मिला है ना, that is due to this charge, only this singular charge. Are you getting it my point? Yes, student. हाँ. और अगर यहाँ पे capital Q लिखा होता तो मुझे समझ में आया था there will be a contribution of all these charges and their resultant electric field and that in that case I will going to write down capital Q by R square. Isliye student yahan pe E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square mein Q hoga wo charge jo ki us surface vector ke andar enclose hoga. Okay, by making an a three dimensional angle, that is called solid angle. Understood up to here? Yes, student. Abhi ek last main aapko ek question puchne ja raha hu. Let's see kaun iska answer deta. If you clearly observe it, yes, student, if you clearly observe it, this is a spherical shell, three-dimensional hollow sphere. If the charges are distributed over the surface of a spherical shell or the hollow sphere, what kind of a distribution it is? Kaun se type ka distribution hai ye? I will give you a hint. Linear charge distribution, surface charge distribution, or volume charge distribution.
Surface charge
distribution, because these charges are going to be settled over the surface of a sphere. Very good. So now, student, is it clear up to this so that I can go on a next page?
Yes,
sir.
Okay. So now, student,
yeah.
Listen carefully. As you have given me a correct answer that here the distribution is surface charge distribution. Yes. So I will write down the surface charge density, that is surface charge density hota hai sigma equal to, yes, sigma equal to kitna hota hai?
Charge upon area.
Very good. Charge upon area. That's it. So now charge upon area. But now, student, here you have to think wise. You have to think in a two ways. Here you are finding the density, surface charge density of these charges distributed over. See, again and again, I'm repeating. These charges are distributing over the spherical shell or the hollow conductor. It means you have to calculate the density of a charges over this shell, not on the Gaussian surface. Correct? Understood? Where is the distribution taken place? Where is the distribution taken place? On the sphere shell or on the surface of a sphere shell or hollow sphere. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So now you just tell me, if I wish to calculate the surface charge density for the charge Q, what should be the area? Shall I going to consider the area?
4 pi.
Ah, 4 pi. Bolo, bolo. 4 pi.
Epsilon naught r cube r square.
4 pi r square only. Epsilon naught will not going to come. Because this is just the area of a spherical shell. Understood? यहां तक क्लियर हो गया. हियर आई हैव जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ अ सरफेस एरिया. ओके, करेक्ट है. नाउ ओके, नाउ एज वी हैव ऑब्टेन द इक्वेशन नंबर दिस वन, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी फॉर दिस गॉशियन सरफेस, आई विल कॉल दिस एज इक्वेशन नंबर 3. मैं इसको इक्वेशन 3 बोल देता हूं. अब मैं क्या करता हूं, आई विल कन्वर्ट दिस इक्वेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ और दिस एक्सप्रेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ चार्ज. तो अगर चार्ज ले लेंगे तो क्या होगा, सिग्मा मल्टीप्लाई बाय 4 पाई कैपिटल आर स्क्वायर, एंड आई विल कॉल दिस इक्वेशन नंबर 4. अंडरस्टूड? इज देयर एनी डिफिकल्ट पार्ट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन व्हिच यू वोंट बी अंडरस्टूड फ्रॉम दिस स्टेप? इट इज वेरी सिंपल. यू हैव कैलकुलेट द डेंसिटी. इन टर्म्स ऑफ डेंसिटी यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग द चार्ज. व्हाट इज द चार्ज एक्सप्रेशन? दैट इज सिग्मा टाइम्स 4 पाई आर स्क्वायर. नाउ इफ यू look it onto the equation 3, the equation was E 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Correct? Yes, student? Here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Then it's very simple to substitute the Q value from equation number 4. Equation 4 mein jo Q ka value, wo hum log 3 mein substitute kar dete. Then what I am going to write down? Substitute. Or substituting equation 4 in 3. जो 4 है वो 3 में substitute करेंगे तो expression बनेगा E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. देखो Q was in the numerator. So it is nothing but sigma times 4 pi R square upon. What was there in the denominator? Yes, denominator में क्या था? R square. Okay, small r square. Is there anything is going to be cancel out? कुछ cancel हो रहा है?
4 pi.
ये लो, 4 pi और 4 pi cancel हो गए. Now, what is going to be left here? E equal to sigma capital R square बराबर है epsilon naught small r square. Also, I can write down in the different way that sigma upon epsilon naught capital R, small r, the whole square. Okay, student? Understood this part? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So now,
yes, sir.
Now here, see, we are actually got it two helping hands. One is to find out the electric field intensity by this expression, where if you know the surface charge density directly given into the problem, okay, permittivity ka itna zyada kuch issue nahi hai. We know the permittivity is 8.85 10 raised to minus 12. But if they are going to mentioning spherical shell or this hollow sphere, spherical conductor, which having the radius of some something value, something XYZ value. Also, they are going to mentioning the radius of the Gaussian sphere. So ultimately here we are going to hint that we can easily calculate the electric field intensity if we only know the three quantities. One is surface charge density. Another one is the radiuses of the sphere and the radius of a Gaussian sphere. So by knowing these three quantity, we can easily calculate the electric field intensity. Or agar wo bhi nahi diya hoga, if they are not providing anything, just they're providing you the charge. What is the charge is distributed over the surface of the conductor? And at what distance the electric field intensity we wish to calculate, means that distance is small r. If they are given, if this much data is given, you can easily calculate the electric field intensity. So, dekho student, whenever you will be going to dealing with any problem, see many of time na in a competitive exam, this formula has become the shortcut formula. Okay, ये एक shortcut formula बन जाता है जिससे हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं electric field intensity calculate कर सकते हैं spherical shell का. Okay, spherical shell का electric field intensity we can going to calculate by this shortcut formula by just substituting r and r value. Sigma they will going to providing you and epsilon naught value to we know already. So if you know these three quantities, we can easily calculate electric field intensity. Don't go by traditional method. Ye traditional method se jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. You can simply substitute and calculate the value of electric field intensity. Understood? So please remember, this can be going to help us for the competitive exams problems where we will going to solve the electrostatics MCQs. Okay, so in the MCQ point of view, this is a very important formula. Okay, clear hai?
Yes,
anyone have any doubt regarding about this? Kisi ko koi doubt hai isme? Yes, you can. You please don't hesitate. You can ask freely. Agar kisi ko koi bhi doubt hai isme se. Yes, anyone have any doubt? They can ask. Okay. Acha, chalo. एक टास्क देता हूं आप लोगों को, देखते हैं आप में से कौन अच्छे से उसको अंडरस्टैंड करके मुझे आंसर देता है. ओके, रेडी एवरीवन? आई विल कंसीडर टू केसेस ओवर हियर. यहां पर मैं दो केस ले लेता हूं. दिस इज कॉल्ड केस वन एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड केस टू. वन बाय वन वी विल डिस्कस इट, केस वन केस टू. केस वन इज इफ पॉइंट P is on the surface of conductor. See student, I will again going to explain the case one is, if we have to assume point P is on the surface of a conductor. मतलब ये जो point P है, मतलब ये जो surface area ds किया है, ये पॉइंट पे यहां पे नहीं होके अगर सरफेस के ऊपर ले लेंगे, सो इज देयर गोइंग टू मेक एनी चेंज इन द इक्वेशन और इन द थ्योरी? कुछ चेंज आ सकता है क्या? बताओ. रेडियस क्या? विच रेडियस?
सर द स्मॉल
कैपिटल आर. कैपिटल
आर
यू मीन टू से सर स्मॉल आर का वैल्यू कैपिटल आर के बराबर हो जाएगा?
यस सर.
सही लग रहा है कि नहीं? Tell me honestly, sir, tell me, or honestly speaking, is it be going to be a case where the point P is going to keep it on the surface? तो अगर surface पे रख देंगे, तो अब point P surface पे है. पहले point P का distance center से लेके यहाँ तक का कितना था? It was r, small r. But now ultimately, if the P is kept it on the surface, it will become small r is equal to capital R only. बराबर? Correct है?
Yes.
Now, do one thing na, just substitute into this equation and tell me what will be the electric field intensity. So here electric field intensity E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. Yes, capital R to vaisi hi rahega, but now the smaller value is also become the capital R ka value and square. Ye cut ho jayega and what is the final expression? Batao. Tell me.
Sigma upon epsilon.
अरे वाह, क्या बात है. Well done. Now यहाँ पे हम लोग बोल सकते हैं, now here we can going to say the electric field intensity is also can be calculate if we know. बताओ, who will going to complete the statement? If we know
the surface charge density.
Very good. Well done.
Permittivity
में तो कोई issue है ही नहीं पहले से. That is nothing but the constant 8.85. By just knowing the surface charge density, that is sigma, also you can calculate the electric field intensity. But provided you should know the charge and area. And for finding the area of a conductor, once they has to be providing you the radius of the conductor. Spherical ka radius deke koi matlab nahi banega. It is completely depending on sigma. and that sigma is Q upon A and Q upon 4 pi R square, where R is nothing but the radius of a physical conductor. Understood now? Yes, student. So here ultimately we have calculating the electric field only. So dekho, electric field calculate karne ka equation 3. Then I must say this is equation number 5 and this is equation number 6. So dekho, is tarah se hum log different cases ke liye, different values se we can calculate the electric field intensity. Okay. Provided if the problem contains this much data or the density data, you can easily calculate the electric field intensity. Can I move it for the next part? Yahan tak sabko samajh mein aa gaya, point P agar surface ke upar rakhenge conductor ke to kitna ho jayega, small r is equal to capital R. Yes, student, understood. Shall I proceed?
Yes.
Frankly speaking, ye case samajh mein aaya sabko? Kaise kiya
yes.
Wo?
Yes.
Chalo, let's move yes. It. Let's move it to the next part. If point P is inside the conductor. So if I'm going to placing this point P inside the conductor somewhere here, यहाँ पे रख देते हैं, यहाँ पे पॉइंट पी यहाँ पे रख देते हैं, एनी वेयर, चलो जाने दो, कहीं पे भी रख देते हैं, यहाँ पे रख दिया, चलो पॉइंट पी को, देन इज देयर शिफ्टिंग आउट ऑफ पॉइंट पी फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टू द इनसाइड, इज इट गोइंग टू मेक एनी चेंज इन दिस इक्वेशन, इसमें कोई चेंज मिलेगा क्या, बताओ जल्दी, टेल मी,
द स्मॉल आर विल बी लेस स्मॉलर देन कैपिटल आर.
Small r will be, okay, good, very good. Small r will be, yes, less than capital
less
R.
Than right? Capital R, yeah.
Very good. But now, if this can be happen in this case, the value will be become very small. Exactly. Okay. But here, if I'm talking in terms of E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, your capital R small r value will be, if it is going to write down, the capital R value is almost greater, it will come greater in denominator, okay, because as here we are going to substituting the value of say small r as in terms of capital R. But one, have you observed while placing the point P inside, okay, why we are actually considering this point P in the initial stages? Hum log ne ye point P kyun consider kiya tha initial stage mein? Kya kaam tha apna?
Because the surface was not closed and it was not following, it was not able to follow the Gauss law.
Exactly, very good. But once we have assumed this part and we have just make it this Gaussian surface shell, and afterwards we try to find out the electric field intensity at this point P, okay, this much intensity can be produced at the point level of P. Also this much electric field intensity can be probably find over the surface, near about the surface of the conductor. But now, student, you can go to see clearly here we have enclosing the point P inside the conductor where there is no charge is present. Am I right now?
Yes.
Is there any charge present inside the conductor? Obviously no. Not. Exactly. It is closed. So the point P is right now closed. It is nothing going to make any kind of sense where we are trying to find out the electric field intensity. That's why we are doing this stuff. We are doing this activity. We are placing the point P from say the R distance to capital R distance, and then we are sending them into the point P inside the conductor. Here, this case, we will not obtain any electric field intensity, inside the conductor. So I will directly write down the electric field intensity inside any closed conductor is zero. तो ये सब करके भी कुछ फायदा नहीं आएगा, क्योंकि आप जिस पॉइंट पी को कंसीडर कर रहे हो वो पॉइंट पी ऐसे रीजन में जहां पे कोई चार्ज ही प्रेजेंट नहीं है. अगर कोई चार्ज ही प्रेजेंट नहीं तो पॉइंट पी पे मिलेगा क्या? देयर इज नथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्टेन इनसाइड द conductor because all charges are placed over the surface, not enclosed by the conductor. That's what, that was only the problem, na, in the initial, in the beginning of our assumption. Yes, this was the problem. कि इनसाइड जाके करेंगे क्या, इसलिए तो मैंने बोला था कि शेल को अगर आप तोड़ भी दोगे तो अंदर क्या मिलेगा, अंदर नथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट, देयर इज कंप्लीटली एम्प्टी स्पेस इज प्रेजेंट वेयर द चार्जेस आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. हाँ, अगर ऐसा होता कि चार्जेस अंदर होते तो कोई सेंस बन पाता, बट अभी चार्जेस अंदर है ही नहीं, चार्जेस आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ओवर द सर्फेस. दैट्स इट स्टूडेंट, हियर द एंटायर आइडिया इज क्लियर. देयर इज नथिंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी कैन बी अप्रोचेबल और फाइंड इट इनसाइड द कंडक्टर. तो इनसाइड द कंडक्टर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी जीरो होता है पूरी तरह से. इट इज ओनली ऑब्टेनिंग अराउंड द सरफेस और अराउंड द रीजन ऑफ अ सरफेस एरिया. सो दिस इज व्हाट द केस टू. अंडरस्टूड एवरीवन? तो यहां पे पी इन ई इनसाइड डायरेक्टली जीरो आ जाएगा, एंड दिस रेशियो इज ऑल्सो कमिंग वेरी स्मॉल, ऑलमोस्ट क्लोज टू द जीरो. दैट्स व्हाई. ओके, क्लियर है यहां तक सबको? केस टू समझ में आया? केस टू थोड़ा सा, केस टू में क्या डिफरेंट, वन मोर थिंग, आई जस्ट वांट टू डिस्कसिंग दैट आल्सो इन द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ योर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम. सम टाइम दे आर डूइंग द सेम थिंग. व्हाट दे आर सेइंग इज, हेलो हेलो,
यस सर,
कैन यू हियर मी?
यस सर.
यस, हेलो. Can you hear me?
Yes,
I think, sir, yes. I think I have lost my internet connection. Just a second. Hello, students. Can you hear me?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Audio video is clear, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So now, this is what the electric field intensity and this much stuff, and this is what a proven theory which providing us the idea of the electric field intensity around any charge sphere or hollow sphere, charge conductor basically. And here we will obtain this much different kind of conditions and the expression for electric field intensity. So I was talking about the question type which was generally asking in the competitive exam like NEET and JEE, and that is nothing but student. Sometime they are try to deviate you from the actual question, and that's why they are providing some weird kind of condition. The weird, why I'm calling that as weird condition, why? Because many of us actually going to be deviating by just reading that statement. That find the electric field intensity inside the charge conductor at a point of say 5 cm inside. Now, once the student read the statement, he or she directly start calculating electric field intensity. Are yahan charge pata hai, and then distance they are given. But now, student, as it is clearly mentioned in the problem, here the point P is considering inside the shell. And its distance is somewhat 5 cm. Okay, here I'm just considering as an example. I'm not touching the actual problem here, but I'm just telling you that point P is considering inside the conductor at 5 cm from the center of a conductor. Obviously, here it is clarified that wherever the point P, okay, more than that, the radius value will be greater. जहाँ पे भी point P है ना, वो डिस्टेंस के कंपैरिजन में तो रेडियस ऑफ द स्फीयर तो बड़ा होगा. ओके, अगर 5 cm पे पॉइंट पी रखा है तो 10 cm तो उस शेल का रेडियस होगा. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? मैं क्या बोलने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ?
यस,
क्लियर है? यहाँ पे जो पॉइंट पी है ना, वो ऐसे पॉइंट पे लिया है कि सपोज इफ इट इज एट 5 cm, तो हो सकता है मे बी द कंप्लीट रेडियस ऑफ द शेल इज कैपिटल आर. That will be 10 centimeter. I'm just taking an example, standard example, so that you can go into be clear your mind. But student, many of us directly start calculating by using this formula, or ya to fir ye formula, ye sab formula use karna start kar dete, aur fir baad mein kuch to ek example mein kuch matlab kuch ek rough calculation aa jata hai, kuch numerical value aa jata hai with consist of power, and then we try to searching in the four option mein start kar dete hai dekhna kaun sa ऑप्शन करेक्ट है. कभी कभी ऐसा हो जाता है, समटाइम लकीली इट हैज हैपेंड, और अनफॉर्चुनेटली आई कैन से unfortunately, this is going to happen. We obtain some value which can be close to the some false values of the options. And then we are directly not thinking on the concept and directly market and then ho gaya khatam. But these kind of questions are purposely, deliberately putting in the into the examination so that they want to find or they want to just say, what is your ability of thinking towards the problem? What will be your approach towards the problem? So that's why sometime they are giving you the radiuses and the distances and they start confusing, they start deviating you. So student, please be careful about it. Please read, first of all, try to read it, try to understand, analyze the concept and then only go for the further calculation. It may be going to spoil your time, that precious time where you can going to be solve some other questions also. Okay, so it's my better say suggestion to you people that you please first of all try to understand the problem, try to analyze it and then only go for the further kind of calculation and stuff. Don't directly jump for the calculation. Ha, calculation aa gaya, fatafat kar lete hain, answer dekhte hain, char mein se option. Please sometime think on the all four sides of the critical, okay, of the critical conditions of the problem. So this is only my suggestion. Okay, you will come across such kind of problems. Don't worry. So this is what the electric field intensity we have calculated. Understood everyone up to this? Yahan pe kisi ko koi confusion hai? Aur please jo maine aapko yes. क्लियर है कि किसी को anyone have any doubt?
Sir.
Yes, tell me.
So in case to the value of sigma and epsilon zero would be also zero, right?
Exactly. That will be also become zero, na? Because there is no density present. But where which density we try to calculate? अगर हम लोग density का value लिखेंगे तो क्या लिखेंगे? Q upon 4 pi. I will say r dash. कुछ तो एक random r dash ले लेते हैं. वो आर डैश क्या होगा? दैट इज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस पॉइंट पी टू द सेंटर. आई विल से दिस इज आर डैश. ओके, वी विल ऑब्टेन द डेंसिटी, बट दैट डेंसिटी इज ओनली द ज्योमेट्रिकल डेंसिटी, नॉट द डेंसिटी ऑफ अ चार्ज, बिकॉज देयर इज नथिंग इज प्लेस्ड ओवर द सरफेस एरिया विच आई कैन गोइंग टू रीफॉर्म रीजनरेट बाई कंसिडरिंग दिस पॉइंट पी. इसलिए यहां पर डेंसिटी भी फिजिकली जीरो हो जाएगा. चार्ज डेंसिटी, चार्ज डेंसिटी आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, नॉट अ ज्योमेट्रिकल डेंसिटी. ज्योमेट्रिकल डेंसिटी तो कुछ ना कुछ मिल ही जाएगा ना. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट?
यस सर.
चार्ज डेंसिटी इज डिफरेंट वेयर यू आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द डेंसिटी ड्यू टू द चार्जेस, बट वेयर इफ पॉइंट पी यू कंसिडर एंड यू मेक इट एन इमेजिनरी सर्कल और इमेजिनरी स्फीयर, यू विल बी गेट द डेंसिटी, बट डेंसिटी ऑफ द स्फीयर और द इमेजिनरी शेल. But that is not the density for the charges with respect to, because there is nothing is present on the, so charge distribution density would be zero. Very good. That's the thing. So density is also become zero. Charge density. Okay.
So.
Yes.
Why we took solid angle?
Why we took a solid angle? Okay. See. If you imagine, say. A football or basketball or any kind of a spherical shell, any kind of spherical shell, the charge which is placed it na, see, I will want to say the, see, if this surface area is like somewhat in the curved nature like this, so charges can be present at any position, can be present on this position and this position like this. So charges are not distributed uniformly on the flat surface, but they are distributed over the curved surface like this. Okay, for that reason, if the charge position, if I'll mark the charge position, and obviously it will enclosed or enveloped or encapsulated by the Gaussian sphere, which is again the kind of spherical in nature, that charge intensity is proceeding toward the Gaussian surface in the three dimensional way. So the electric field is not moving only in the singular direction, but the electric field is due to the single point charges. They are actually distributing. Their electric field is distributing all the 360 degree. एक single charge होता है ना, वो अपने around 360 degree में electric field को expand कर सकता है. So what component we are considering now? For that component, we have to enclose the charge under the solid angle. Let me give you an example, very simplest and finest example. Whenever we say roaming around the market sometime, so we will find the watermelon. Okay, so that vendor is not going to cut the watermelon completely and then show it to you. Ye dekho, ye ekdam fresh hai, abhi leke jao. He is not doing. His marketing strategy is different. What he is doing? Can anyone tell me? वो क्या करता है पता है? मैंने देखा होगा
मैंने. Cut a small piece.
हाँ, exactly. He cut a piece of a small section which is of the triangular one. When he remove it, we will obtain the three-dimensional angle or the three-dimensional caps or the three-dimensional cavity inside the.
Sir, like pyramid, right?
Pyramidal, yes, very good. Pyramidal, exactly. So this is the only thing. When we are removing that caps or when we are removing that cavity, we will obtain the space region. Na? So that space region is indicating if some seed is going to be placed over there. So that seed is actually inculcepted by or encapsulated by that three-dimensional geometrical angle. That's why I'm showing this by solid angle. And you know na, the solid angle value will be of 4π for any three-dimensional geometry. It is given in your first chapter called Units and Measurement, where the solid angle and the plane angle are the two supplementary units. Okay? Understood?
Yes.
That's why we are using the solid angle. Yes, very good. Yes, anyone have any question or any doubt so that I can go into the proceed for the next part. Yahan tak sabko clear ho chuka hai? क्या किया है ये दो केसेस एंड अलोंग विद दिस एक्सप्रेशन शैल आई प्रोसीड फॉर द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ओके चलो सो नाउ गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट एप्लीकेशन सो दिस वाज द फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज स्फेरिकल शेल और द होलो स्फीयर नाउ वी हैव टू गो इनटू द अनदर एग्जांपल और अनदर केस वेयर वी विल कंसीडर द डिफरेंट शेप ऑफ कंडक्टर एंड ट्राई टू फिगर आउट what will be the expecting electric field intensity near about it. Okay, so now our assumption is to calculate, yes, this is the second application based on the Gauss's law where I am trying to find out electric field intensity. Dekho, ye sab common hi rahega, electric field intensity due to an infinitely long as well as straight charged hai uske upar charge deposited hai of wire. So this is what student our next aim is to find out the electric field intensity due to infinitely long straight charged wire. First upon, again, we have to set our mind so that we will going to find out a equation in terms of E. So here, the equation, whatever will be coming, the final result will be coming, that will be in terms of E. But now, our conductor has been changed. Now it is not a spherical one. It's a straight charged wire. And one more thing, it is infinitely long. So that I don't know where it will be going to start and when it will be going to be end. So the end and the final part or the initial and the final part of the terminals of this wire, I don't know. I just know one thing that this is the straight charged wire, which means the charge are already distributed across a length of a charge wire. Student, if you clearly observe the charge wire, okay? Any kind of a charge wire, charge conductor, charge wire. If you just enlarge it, then you will going to get its geometrical shape will be resembled to one of the standard geometrical shape. Can anyone tell me which shape is resembled to the charge wire?
Cylindrical.
Sorry. Cylindrical. Very good. Cylindrical. Exactly. So cylindrical shape and the shape of a wire will be remain as like a same. They are identically looking in the same dimension. So now, again, for this expression, we have to assume it again one of the geometrical shape of a conductor. So here we are comparing the charge wire with the cylinder. That's why I'm going to draw it one cylindrical shape of conductor like this. Okay, ये एक cylindrical shape of conductor हम लोग ने consider कर लिया जो कि अपना charged wire है इस तरह से like this. Okay, and here this is what the center of axis which is passing through this conductor. ये इसका axis region है which is passing through the center of the conductor. Now if I try to calculate the distance from this central axis to the end portion of a cylindrical or charged wire, I will call this is the radius. Am I right? Yes, everyone. Sometime I can go to, so this is also the radius one. This is also the radius of a cylinder. Okay?
Yes.
So capital R is the radius of a cylinder. Okay, student? Followed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
जाए आगे अभी, shall we proceed? Next part is, as it is mentioned, infinitely long straight charge wire. So let us distribute the charge over the length. चलो यहाँ पे charges को distribute कर देते हैं. So in this way, charges are distributed over the length of this conductor. Okay. So अभी again the same thing जैसे यहाँ पे हुआ था. Initially we have drawn the physical conductor in this way, in this sense. Physical conductor बना लिया था, physical conductor के ऊपर charges को distribute कर दिया था as it is. Here also same thing was happened. We have considering the physical charged wire and we have distribute the charges over the length. Now again the same thing comes. If we want to calculate the electric field intensity created due to these charge distribution, I want to calculate the electric field intensity near about this charge wire. Yes, मेरा aim ये होगा कि electric field intensity कितना present है, वो मुझे यहाँ पे calculate करना है. But calculate करे तो भी कैसे करे? How we can going to calculate? Because again the same situation is arriving at in front of us is these charges are not enclosed. They are right now free. They can going to be seen in the free state. ना यहाँ पे तो ये free में दिख रहा है, तो ये ऊपर है, ये यहाँ पे है. They all are present in the like a medium. But now the again same thing or same condition is happened to us is we can't going to use the Gauss's law. Gauss law वापस use नहीं कर सकते हैं. कभी क्या करेंगे? What is the another option? Can anyone tell me? Gauss law use नहीं कर सकते. तब करें तो क्या करें? What we can going to do? Yes, any idea?
Oh, maybe we have to consider one closed figure, Gaussian surface.
Exactly. Again, we have to consider one closed figure like of a Gaussian surface. So yes, let us try to draw one imaginary Gaussian surface in a such a way it also resembled to look like a cylinder only. So here I have drawn the Gaussian surface with respect to our charge wire. Okay. And student, as you can going to see, this Gaussian cylinder, I will call this as Gaussian cylinder because it is made up of the Gaussian surfaces only. So this is what the Gaussian cylinder has radius up to here is smaller. Again, the same thing, Gaussian surface, Gauss cylinder is bigger than the actual physical conductor. So its distance from the center of axis of the physical conductor to the Gaussian's end surface or the end portion, this is nothing but small r. Okay, student. So again, the same thing has happened over here. If you compare it between the small r and capital R, our small r is greater. Understood up to here? Shall I proceed? यहां तक सबको clear है?
Yes.
Now the thing is, student, yes, this Gaussian cylinder or the Gaussian surface also has some length because we have draw it very limited and restricted way. No, that's why we have to consider this much length of the Gaussian surface only. Yes, this is our say Gaussian surface which we have draw it for our for our conveniency. Now again, the same thing is going to happen if I want to calculate the electric field intensity of the charges which is enclosed by the Gaussian surface. I have to consider one point P. Here I will consider the point P where I will draw it one surface area vector. This is what my surface area vector. This surface area vector is ds vector. This is surface area vector ds vector. Okay, understood? So now I can say this ds is also at the same distance, no sir? Yes, everyone?
Yes, sir.
It is also at the distance of small r only, no? Yes, exactly. From the axis of center of the cylinder or the axis of center of the charge wire, this is also at a distance r. Now, student, as you can see, the electric field which is creating due to these charges, which are engulfed by the Gaussian surface, their electric field will be tried to travel it toward the point P of this surface area ds, and they will come out like this. So as you can see, the ds is also in the same direction and electric field is also in the same direction. Again, the same thing, same situation is obtained. Theta is zero. Between whom? Between ds vector and electric field intensity. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, ds ka jo direction hai, ds ka direction aur electric field ka direction dono same ho gaya. So again, the theta is become zero. Understood up to this? Now, everyone,
yes, sir.
Clear hai? Badhte aage phir. Now, again, same thing is going to happen. We will calculate the flux, electric flux. What is electric flux? Electric flux is close integral of E vector dot ds vector. Okay? Understood up to this? E yes, vector sir. Dot ds vector. Now, let us expand this again in the same way, E ds cos theta. Again, close integral E ds cos of 0 degree. As we all know, cos 0 is 1, close integral E ds. Again, the same thing, we know the electric field intensity is actually going to be contributed by these charges which are engulfed inside the Gaussian surface. So their electric field intensity never going to change because the charges are remain the same. Jo bhi charges is Gaussian surface ke andar enclosed ho chuka hai, utna hi electric field intensity apne ko milega. So it is again the conservation. Electric field never going to be changed. So electric field is constant. So I will take E outside the close integral and ds. Okay. Now again the debate is going to take place in between us. If someone comes and say, hey, sir, why you are considering this point P? Why you are considering this surface area ds? Do one thing, sir. Yahan pe le lijiye aap. Koi bolega, sir, yahan pe bana le lijiye. Sir, you can go to draw it here. Ultimately, the final conclusion is you can go to select any of kind or any random ds surfaces over the entire Gaussian surface. Matlab, aap koi bhi position pe ds, matlab surface area vector, aap select kar sakte ho. या तो सबने अगर कंसीडर कर लिया, सबने सोचा कि सर हम सब लोग मिलके यहाँ पे सरफेस एरिया बना लेते, तो एवरीवन इज गोइंग टू मेक देयर ओन सरफेस एरियाज एंड दिस एंटायर गॉशियन सरफेस इज कंप्लीटली डिस्टिंग्विश्ड बाय देयर ओन इंडिविजुअल गॉशियन ओके सरफेसेस बाय इंडिविजुअल सरफेस एरिया वेक्टर्स एंड अल्टीमेटली इफ आई एम गोइंग टू कंबाइन देम, अगर सबका सरफेस एरिया अगर मैं कंसिडर करता हूँ सबको कंबाइन कर देता हूँ, what is the ultimate result I will obtain? Kya milega?
Again a cylinder.
Again and cylinder. Very good. Again and cylinder. So now the point is E into, if I'm going to take the integration of all the small surface areas elements over here, I may obtain the area of cylinder, that is 2 pi r l. Am I right?
Yeah.
Is this expression is correct?
Yes. Yeah.
Very good. Now this is equation one for me, that is E into 2 pi RL, where 2 pi RL is coming from taking the integration of all the surface area vectors. Now again, we have to say according to, according to, according to G Gauss's law. What Gauss's law say? E is equal to close integral A dot ds is equal to q upon epsilon naught. Now its part is clear. Is this part is clear to you all? I will call this equation number 2.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Kya karte? Let us say, sir, again, from 1 and 2. Let us compare them because both of them are representing the electric flux only. I will write down E into 2 pi R into L Q upon epsilon naught. Can I ask you one question, student? Why we are doing this all stuff? To finding what?
Electric field intensity.
Exactly, electric field intensity. Electric field intensity we are calculating because E equal to this term goes on right hand side 2 pi epsilon naught. Yes, student? This can be a Q. They got 2 pi epsilon naught and this must be R into L. So this entire 2 pi RL will be go onto the denominator side and we will obtain this is the equation 3, which is electric field intensity due to infinitely charged long wire. Okay, long straight wire. So itna electric field intensity can be obtained near the charged conductor, which is of in the shape of wire. So this is what E equal to 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught Q upon R into L. Is it clear? Yahan tak sabko clear hai?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Sure na? Ye kaise aaya, sabko samajh mein aa gaya? Ye 2 pi RL kya hai? What is this 2 pi RL?
Surface area
of cylinder. Sorry, pardon? Surface area of cylinder. Okay, that is the integral of surface area. Barabar, surface area vector. Very good. So now this is what the equation number 3. Now again, student, if you just look at carefully on the surface of charged wire, the charges are, forget about this Gaussian surface and everything. Just carefully observe on this charged wire, the charges are distributing in which manner? On what way they are distributing? Again, the option is linearly, surfacely, or volume?
Surface.
Are you sure? Look at carefully.
Volume.
They are not placed inside or they are not occupying the space over here.
So linearly.
Why? Because they are residing, they are just placing on the length of this conductor. Yes. They are not placed somewhere on the other edges. They are only keep it on the length. That's why the density would be linear charge density. Is it clear? It's still you have any confusion about the distribution regarding about this place? Ki ye linearly hai ki surfacely hai? Dekho, surfacely case mein kaisa hota hai? If this is the sphere region, the charges are placed somewhere like this. So the charges are placing on the surface. That's why surface charge density aa jayega. Ab yahan pe kaisa hai? What has happened here in this case? If this is the conductor, I'm just taking an example. If this is a conductor, so the charges are only distributed along the length. Along this length, charges are distributed. And along this length of the side, charges are distributed. They are not distributed overly, completely. Understood this part?
Yes.
So is it be clear about the distribution?
Yes.
Pakka? Aage jate hai? Shall we proceed for the next part?
Yes.
Okay, now student, listen carefully. So this is what equation 3. Again, we should go into recall the density. And our density was linear charge density. Linear charge density is Q by L. Am I right? Q by L. Therefore, what is Q? Q is lambda into L. Correct? Q is lambda into
yes,
n.
Sir, yes.
I will call this equation number 4. I will call this as equation number 4. Now, student, this equation number 4 will help us to find out the electric field intensity of equation 3. So I will again substitute. In 3, the value of 4. The value of 4 is going to be distribute or substituting in equation 3. What was the equation 3? Equation 3 was E equal to 1 upon, ek bar dekh lete wapas, 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught. Okay. In place of Q, I will substitute lambda into L upon R into L. Anything is going to be get cancelled from numerator to denominator. Length is going to cancel. Now we will be having equation called 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught. Yes, my dear student, 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught. What will be left here?
Lambda by R.
And this is the required electric field intensity around the infinitely long straight charged wire. By knowing only the two quantities, it is sufficient to calculate the electric field intensity. Is nothing but lambda and R. Once you know the linear charge density and the distance up to the point where we have assumed it, the electric field intensity can be obtained. Okay, so these two quantities can be help us to find out the electric field intensity near the charge conductor. So this was the expression E is equal to 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught lambda by R. Yes, student, understood this? Clear? Eh?
Yes,
anyone sir. Have any difficulty or koi bhi aisa step jo aapko nahi samjha ho, please ask. Shall I proceed for the next part? Now, student, if you remember in the previous lecture, I have told you about, or you may know, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. What was the entire value of this 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught? Anyone knows?
9 into 10 raised to 9.
Very good. 9 into 10 raised to 9. Okay. This is the entire numerical constant value of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. That you know, you can do it this calculation, you will obtain or you will get the same expression called 9 into 10 to the power 9 by simply putting the 8.85 10 raised to minus 12 in place of epsilon naught. 4 you know, pi value 3.142. Do the multiplication of the denominator, take the reciprocal, you will get 9 into 10 raised to 9. This is the order. But now the problem is, while you are doing this kind of problem, which or the equation of this electric field intensity doesn't have in the form of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Rather than it would be, I can say it is in the form of 2 pi epsilon naught lambda by R. If you look at carefully our previous equation, kahan pe gaya? Our previous equation, E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Only the difference between these equations are the numerical constant 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught and 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. If this is the case, it is very easy to calculate the 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught value. You can directly substitute as 9 into 10 to the power 9. No need to calculate, no need to take it anything. You simply, while doing the calculation, you simply substitute the value 9 into 10 to the power 9. But in this case, you can 9 into 10 to the power 9 ekdam easily substitute. In this case, you can't do it because this is 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught. You have a two ways. Number one, do one thing. Put the value of epsilon naught, 8.85 10 raised to 12, then multiply by 3.142 and multiply by 2, find out the denominator value and take the reciprocal. This is the one step. Correct? Aisa kar sakte hai? Understood everyone? फॉलोड ना, आप एप्सिलॉन नॉट का वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूट कर दो 3.142 एंड मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2, ये पूरा कैलकुलेट करके जो भी वैल्यू आएगा उसका आप एप्सिलॉन सॉरी उसका आप रेसिप्रोकल ले लो. दिस इज द वन वे. कैन यू टेल मी इज देयर एनी अदर वे ऑफ फाइंडिंग द सेम कांस्टेंट वैल्यू?
Or otherwise, 9 × 10⁻¹⁹
Pardon?
So could we divide 9 × 10⁻¹⁹
by 2? Okay, if I'm going to try to divide this by 2, so you mean to say 1/4πε₀ value is divided by 2, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this 2 will be go into the denominator again. Am I right?
Yes,
sir. So this will make 8π₀. But 1/8πε₀ value can't be taken as this, no? 9 × 10⁹.
So your 2 is in the denominator. So there we can put it in the numerator.
This 2 you're talking about?
No, sir. In the above step.
Actually, you are talking about this 2 means 1 upon, but here you mean to say 9 × 10⁹ divided by 2, na? That you want to make a half of this.
Okay.
Correct, no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So as it is, I am just dividing by both the side by 1/2 or by the 2. So this 2 will goes on the denominator again, no? That is nothing but A upon B upon C. That is A upon B into C. So in this form, the 2 will be going to multiply by 8π₀.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So
this numerical value, again, you will going to calculate now 1 upon and this. It may be coming like you are taking the half of 9 × 10⁹. Correct. But one more easiest way is you can simply multiply and divide this term by 2. Why? Can anyone tell me? Or what is the use of multiply divide by 2? Yes, in this term, if I multiply divide by 2, what easily I can obtain? I can take this one as it is. The denominator 2 multiply by 2, that will be 4π₀. And the 2 which is multiplied in the numerator will be give you 2λ/r. Now it is possible not to substitute 9 × 10⁹.
Yes.
So this is the way. So please remember, while solving the problem regarding about the cylinder, that time they always going to give you 1/2πε₀. So kya karna hai aapko? You have to simply just multiply divide by 2 so that make this value as 4π₀, and this 2 will be multiplied to the linear charge density lambda. So please don't be get confused whenever they will give you 1/2πε₀ value, or simply if the problem will come based on the cylinder, we have to use this formula because this is a standard formula. But while doing the calculation, we don't know the 1/2πε₀ value. We can calculate, but it will take time. It has become much tedious. Again, to multiply 8.85 to the 3.142, multiply by 2 and then reciprocal. Why doing this all stuff? Why we are going to wasting our time? Simply just 2 se multiply kar do ke, divide kar do ke, to 1/4πε₀ ka value to we know already. Only the thing is, the 2 which is multiplied, na, that will be goes to the linear charge density. So whatever the linear charge density is already given into the problem, you have to multiply that by 2. So please remember, this is also the way you can do the calculation part of the electric field intensity, okay, around the charge conductor. So this is what the expression. Here again, if you compare the same equations, if you again compare the same equations like cases 1 and cases 2, I am hand over it to you that you can find out, okay, this is what your home assignment where you have to find out the electric field intensity if the point P exactly present on the surface of a conductor, and again, if the point P is present inside the charge conductor. So again, you have to considering two cases. Here, the cases are going to be defined according to the point play or the point position. On the basis of that, you have to student derive the expression of electric field intensity for the charged one. So can you all do this? आप लोग कर सकोगे? Try करना. अगर गलत आता है तो I will going to tell you in the next lecture. Okay, so this is the home assignment where you have to considering the two cases of point P lies exactly on the surface of a charged conductor long straight wire, but otherwise point P will be lying inside. जिसका answer आपको ultimately पता है. I'm not going to discussing it furthermore, but that point P if is going to be taken inside, you know the what is the result. Okay, I'm just giving you as an like a step of calculation, but please try to calculate where the point P if it is placed on the charge conductor, what can be the probable equation or the expression for the electric field intensity of a charge wire. So this you can going to be considered as your home assignment. Okay, understood up to this student? Yahan tak sab kuch clear ho chuka hai? Yes, student.
Yes, sir.
So today we have calculated the two electric field intensities of a two different shape of conductor. One was the hollow sphere shell and another one is a charge conductor. But now the third expression or the third possible case is very simple. It's very, very, very simple. There is no such complexity was added or will be say has to consider in this expression because it's itself defining in the very simplest form. So the third application is electric field intensity due to charge, मतलब ये charged है already, charge infinite plane sheet, plain sheet or plain paper. Bobby, your hold on. So we have to find out the electric field intensity, which means E we have to calculate. But with respect to which conductor, which kind of shell, which kind of say the property. So here the plane sheet we have to consider. But that is the charged one and it is infinite. So I don't know where it is completely occupied by the surrounding space. But now for our assumption, I have considered this plane paper. On this plane paper, I will distribute the charge. Like this, ये एक plain paper है, बहुत ही thin paper है, इसके ऊपर charges को distribute कर लिया, just assume it, इस तरह से, and then what they are asking, if I place this plane like this, in this way, okay, so what will be the electric field intensity? Can you see this? Yes, student. Will you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
So now the plane paper is like placing in a such a way that, so the positive charge is placed on the plane paper, okay? And we have to calculate the electric field intensity near about this region and also electric field intensity near about this region. Please don't be consider this as ki ye physical paper or paper ke upar rakha hua hai. It's a plane basically, okay? It's in a transparent plane. So definitely this positive charge can be observed from this side and also from this side. So ye jo charge hai na, ye ek physical plane ke upar, matlab plane ke upar hai, kisi plane ya paper ke upar nahi hai. Agar paper ke upar hoga to aap bologe ki sir charge to sirf yahan se dikhai de raha hai. Charge is not going to be observing from this side. Exactly, you are correct. That's why I'm not going to say ki this is the plane, this is the paper, this is the basically the plane. ओके ये कोई पेपर नहीं है, ये एक प्लेन शीट है जो कि बहुत ही थिन है. तो अब यहाँ पे क्या होगा, अगर ये चार्ज इस तरह से डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो चुके हैं तो व्हाट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी अराउंड दिस प्लेन, ये अपने को कैलकुलेट करना है. Understood up to this? So ये case आपको समझ में आ गया? Okay? So you have to calculate the electric field intensity about here and electric field intensity about here. So electric field intensity दोनों side में कितना होगा? तो obviously equal होगा क्योंकि ये charge एक plane के ऊपर है. तो यहाँ से जितना electric field intensity grow करेगा, same electric field intensity यहाँ से भी उतना ही grow करेगा. There is no discrepancy or there is no in the difference in the magnitude of the electric field creating. क्योंकि चार्ज यूनिफॉर्म है, that's why. So student, here I will draw it quickly and a plane sheet which is consist of charges. Charges है इसके पास ऐसे, इस तरह से. Okay, now we have to calculate the electric field intensity. अब क्या होगा पता है क्या स्टूडेंट? से some of them are going to say, sir, again we have to consider a Gaussian surface, am I right? अब तो आदत हो गई है Gaussian surface, conductor दिखा कि नहीं Gaussian surface बनाना start, correct? Now it's become a habit to us that whenever we will see the any charge conducting or conductor, charge conductor, we start drawing the Gaussian surface. But now student, here if I try to draw the Gaussian surface, so obviously the Gaussian surface will be of like a cube, am I right?
Yes sir.
A cube banana padega fir.
Yes sir.
Okay, so that is also can be possible. We will go to say the cube, we have to make a imaginary cube we have to take and just assume that this plane of paper is presenting in that cube. Correct? Hello. Yeah, thank you. Okay. So that is also one of the way you can go to find out. But now the thing is, if I'm considering, please listen carefully, student. This is very, very important and it's really strike your mind. If I'm going to draw it the cube of a Gaussian surface, obviously I have to consider all the charges which are placed one by one. And for them, I have to draw their surface area ds, 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 like this. Like if I close it, if I draw it this kind of Gaussian surface, like this. And in between that, the plane escaped it. Ye wo plane hai. Okay. And this plane contains these number of charges. So all charge will send their electric field intensity toward this surface or this face of a cube. Similarly, on the back side of this face. And again, we have to consider all the single point, and that point R can be become, this time there will be no a point P. There will be number of points, say P1, P2, P3, because this is a Gaussian surface and this Gaussian surface not enclosing single charge, but they are enclosing total set of charge. So all charges will create their own electric field intensity. And for them, what we need to do, we will going to draw the all small surface areas over here. But it is again become the difficult part, because the number of charges are more. So in this case, what is the convenient idea? What is the convenient idea? Let us figure out, or let us focus on this charge. Is charge ko consider kar lete hain. Is charge ke aage a cylindrical Gaussian surface bana lete hain. It is just like assume ke ek pipe le liya hai, aur wo pipe ko paper mein se insert kar diya, to wo jo paper hai, उस पेपर पे जो पॉजिटिव चार्ज था, नाउ दैट पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज एनक्लोज बाय दैट पाइप. अब ये पाइप कौन है पता है? ये भी आपका एक गॉशियन सरफेस ही है, ये भी एक गॉशियन सिलेंडर है. अब यहाँ पे एक पॉइंट पी ले लेता है, आई सेट पॉइंट पी, और यहाँ पे ले लेते हैं पॉइंट पी डैश, बिकॉज दीज आर सिमेट्रिकली बरोबर. ये पॉइंट पी यहाँ पे लिया है ना, जितने डिस्टेंस पे उतना ही ये डिस्टेंस पे प्रेजेंट होना चाहिए. And here we have assumed the Gaussian cylinder, which is only going to englobe the single point charge. And it is at distance R from paper's plane or plane's paper position to the point P, and this is R dash from plane's position charge to the P dash. So now, if this is the surface area, I will say ds vector. Electric field will comes out throughout this Gaussian cylinder due to this positive charge, and there are come out like this. यहाँ से निकलेगा E vector. यहाँ से भी निकलेगा E vector because electric field are going both the direction, going on right hand side and left hand side as well as. So now, what we can going to do? We can find out total flux. Okay, through total flux through the closed surface, that is nothing but phi is equal to, let us use the closed integral E dot ds or E vector dot ds vector for point P plus close integral E vector dot ds vector for the another prime point P dash. Because see student, your flux are generated how many times? Flux kitne bar generate hone wala hai yahan pe?
Two times.
Two times.